So, ang feeling ko is that we should speak out. We cannot remain silent. We have to speak out every opportunity and talk about our victory in the arbitral tribunal. Thank you, Madam.
As you said po kanina, the only thing we can do is diplomatic pressure. So para yun po sa China. But compared to China po, we are a very small country. What kind of diplomatic pressure can we do po to China?
We have to set up alliances. As I said, we are not without allies. Ang dami, halos lahat kapalit kaibigan natin. I already mentioned India is very friendly to us because of congruent interests. You know, common interests make friends. You know, pag very common interests, nagiging friendly kayo. Common enemies also make friends. Akalaban mo rin ba si, ano, si yung babae na yan? Ako, yung babae yan. Happy tayo dito. Sa bahay talaga yan. Ganun eh. Di ba? Ganun. So, that's how it is. Japan is worried about China because Japan is too aggressive in the Senkakos area. Indonesia is very worried because China is encroaching into their Natuna Island sa may labas na ng South China Sea. So, ang Vietnam lalo na. Talagang matindi ang laban nila dyan sa Paracels, sa oil development. And, you know, one very good model for how to handle this situation is the way Vietnam is doing it. Vietnam is smaller than the Philippines. Their GDP is about two-thirds our GDP. They have less GDP. Their population is smaller than our population. They're very close to Vietnam, so the threat is more immediate, but they're handling themselves very well. They're able to develop a very strong military, not strong enough, but enough to give China a headache. I believe that we should do the same thing. Because if Vietnam can buy modern warplanes like Sukhoi 27, Sukhoi 30, six submarines, kilo-class submarines from Russia, missiles from Russia, and then have a tie-up with India for the training of their Sukhoi pilots and the crew of their submarines, we can do the same thing without affecting our economic engagement. Hindi pwedeng zero. That's why we have to also beef up our armed forces. Indonesia is doing that now. India is doing that now. Australia, because of the threat, they just allocated about $35 billion for submarines. India has two aircraft carriers, a lot of warplanes, a lot of submarines. US, same time. British, England will go inside. France is already has already announced that they will enter the South China Sea because they still have territory in the Pacific, yung New Caledonia area, that's still a French colony. And England will deploy some warplanes in Japan. So, now in terms of economic engagement, EU has a total GDP of about $17 trillion. So they're a very good source of market for our export. We have about 500,000 OFWs deployed in the EU countries, Spain, France, Italy, Germany. So, may pakinabang tayo, nagbibigay sila ng aid sa atin. What China can do, the other countries can do also. If we have a very good balanced diplomacy, which is what the Foreign Service is all about. Yes.
Sir, good afternoon. I know si Santi po, I'm the faculty of the Foreign Service students po. Thank you for the insightful presentation. I would just like to know your insights, sir, because in relation to what you have said, one of the pressure that we could take against China is through the alliances that we have. But we all know that the president right now is actually bad-mouthing much of those we've mentioned as our prospective alliances. Do you think this will affect the pressure, if ever? Because like EU, the president has said so many bad things about EU in the recent. So later on about this issue, can it affect the pressure we want to push for China?
Well, I really don't know. I cannot speak for EU. Pero siyempre, tao din yung mga nandun eh. Sa tao, pag medyo may narinig kami, yun na lang, may pinulong sila. Alam mo ba, sinabi ni Mary sa'yo, huwag na lang, magagalit ka lang. Hindi ko na sasabihin. Ganun ka na sigurado doon, di ba? Wala ka narinig. So now, we have this press bullet ranting against the EU. Because of intervention, which is also maybe pointed the president in intervention in our domestic policy. But if we would like to have a balanced diplomatic policy, what is worse, you ask me? Intervention by interfering in our peace and order policy, or intervention by claiming and actually occupying our exclusive economic zone? That is intervention. Preventing us from developing oil in Reed Bank near Palawan. Threatening war, sabi nga, magkikirahin daw tayo pag dig tayo ng oil dun sa may Reed Bank or Recto Bank. So what is, isn't that intervention also? Dapat murahin din natin yung China. Para patas-patas, di ba? Patay lang. But in fairness back to the EU, in spite of that, they look at it as part of the background noise, part of diplomacy. They do not create permanent injuries. There's something to cope with. So they're still offering grants. Tuloy pa rin yung offer nila. Yung America, sabi, titigil na yung balikitan. Pero hindi naman. Hindi rin natigil. Because I think the armed forces realizes that those exercises are also important. Tingnan yung nangyari sa Marawi. Diba? Sino ang mga nakatulong na gusto sa Marawi? The US, they sent equipment, rifles, P-3 Orion, yung drone sharing intelligence. Ang dami tumulong. Yun naman maganda rin. Also, again, in fairness to the president, because of that positioning, everybody is now competing for our attention. Parang nagpapaligaw tayo. Pero minsan, mahirap din yung masyado kang ngalaw, di ba? Pag masyado kang pakipot sa lahat, they might all end up saying, ayaw sa akin, isa na ako. They all live together. So you have to balance that. This is a very delicate thing. Country relationships, also personal relationships, people talk of congruent interests, common interests, and also common threats. In the case of India, I think India has a 3,000 or 4,000 kilometer common boundary with China, and that has been an irritant for hundreds of years. Same with Vietnam, and that is a permanent threat to them. In fact, about a month ago, there was a showdown in the Doklam area, sa Bhutan area, when China deployed some soldiers there for the purpose of constructing a road into a corridor which China considers very important in the Bhutan area. So what did India do? They also sent their own troops there. And there was a three-month confrontation there that finally was resolved when China offered a mutual withdrawal. So right now, the nagkaroon ng mutual withdrawal dyan. And a lot of people thought that India won that round dahil umatras ang China. And some people say that the reason why China withdrew was because they knew that in that particular area, India has the geopolitical and even military advantage. Dahil mas marami silang puwersa doon. Now, in the Indian Ocean, the same. China is entering the Indian Ocean with their submarines. Nakakatawang announcement, sabi nila, we will deploy submarines there in order to guard against pirates. Sabi ko, matagal na ako sa nag-aaral ng TV, may pula na balitaan na submarine pala panlaban sa mga pirates. So, pero that's their statement. And India and China has now a base in Djibouti, that is in the Horn of Africa area. Japan, meron din doon. Binanggit ko na yung Diego Garcia, meron base ang United States. Pero medyo tagilid ang China sa loob ng Indian Ocean. Kasi siyempre, daanan niya ng mga tankers nila, mga bahor nila. No? Pag nagkagulo dyan, wala nang dadaan dyan. Pag walang dumaan ng tanker dyan, lugi ang China dahil baka wala sila ng oil. Sa kabila, ano ng Japan? Japan is buying 42, they're buying 42 F-35s, the best fighter plane right now. And the moment they deploy that, that will alter the balance of power in the East Asia area. Of course, yan ang threat ng North Korea, and the U.S. is trying to pressure China to discipline North Korea. Pero ang tingin ko, para naglalaro lang China sa North Korea rito, para takutin yung U.S. So that China will use South China as a bargaining chip. You don't worry with it. Sabi ng China, okay, I will help you in North Korea, pero pabayaan nyo kami sa South China Sea. Lugi naman tayo dyan. Diba? Kasi pag nawala ang U.S., libre na ang China to dominate the South China Sea to our disadvantage. Unless we as a people would say, oh, sige, mula ngayon, kakampi na natin ang China. Tapos na ang treaty natin in America, alis na kayo dito, China na kami. But if we look at the surveys, parang hindi ganun ang gusto ng Pilipino. As of now, the China's rating is very low, US rating is very high. So pag nagkaroon ng referendum, today, I don't know about you, lamang ang US going by the surveys. So yun ang sitwasyon. It's a very, nakakatuwa ang geopolitics. That's why you selected a very exciting topic, geopolitics, foreign service. Go beyond the consular matter. Go to the geopolitical matter. And be conscious of current events. Ang advantage ngayon, noong ako nag-aaral ng ganito, political science in UP, pupunta pa ako sa library, magbabasa pa ako ng diaryo. Eh, i-google mo na lang yung mga daming bagay. Everything I said, you can fact-check by googling. Tama ba sinabi ni Goles na yan? I-google nga natin. Kaya kayo mga professor, ingat kayo. Yes, sir.
Dr. Ron Higgins, sir. In 2012, I directed our foreign service students in their thesis research to make a comparative study of the foreign policy of five countries, namely United States, China, Japan, of course the Philippines, and then Indonesia, which more or less Philippines and Indonesia share almost the same culture. So when we did that research, we found out, I gave them at least